Hey y'all, I got myself a notion. One I know that you understand. That was a goofy movie. Hi, it's me, Tyler Tafoya. Welcome to In the Round with Tyler Tafoya. I'm your host with the most, and if you come for breakfast, you get toast. Tyler Tafoya. Let's see, we gotta do a counter of how many times I say my name in this episode. Joining me as always, my co-host, Anna Ducci. Thank you so much. Hello. Rocking that blue hair.
Thank you.
Looking wild. Love it. Oh man, guys, it's gonna be a good episode today because we got none other than the one, the only Bobby Albright.
Hello, it's me. Thanks for having me.
Thanks for being here. It's good to have you in house.
Yes, in my own house, as it turns out. Exactly. So I'm happy to be here.
Yes, guys, it's gonna be a great episode. As always, we are sponsored by Verb Energy, the caffeinated energy bars. Go click that link on our Instagram. You get $13 off your first purchase of a sample of Verb Energy bars. These are great. Bobby will not eat any of these because he's allergic to peanuts.
Verb, it's what you do. Exactly. Does everyone say that? That's
Verb,
I love
to
it.
Do. There you go. That's the one, yeah. Sean, for those of you who watched our commercial, Sean Condy did the voice and he went, Verb, to do. That's great.
I can make a better commercial. I'm just kidding.
There's time. We can do one tonight.
Okay. Don't challenge me. This is for you, Sean.
We love a good challenge. So Bobby is here today because we, a couple weeks back, we all got involved in something that has been going on for quite a few years now that not the general public know, but the ones who do know have been part of the party for quite some time. It is John's annual lip sync battle. Bobby, care to explain a little bit for the audience who may not know?
Sure. So John, my brother is John, and that's whose lip sync battle it is.
Yes.
And it started officially 5 years ago. This was year five of our official lip sync battle. Mm-hmm. But the idea from it actually started way before that. We had a family friend who was really into the show Lip Sync Battle. I don't know if you guys ever watched the show.
Yeah.
And so they were really into that show Lip Sync Battle. And so they had a graduation party for one of their daughters, and they said, we're going to do a lip sync battle party. And so they had told people in advance, if you want to, you know, and then they're going to have a prize. And so me and my family are very competitive.
Yeah.
And so we all planned out lip syncs. And mm-hmm. then...
Your whole family did?
Yeah, so, that well, sounds... it was me and my brother John, yeah. and then my sister, Beth,
Love
and
that.
Then, so the three of us, and then I don't think David was there, my other brother,
mm-hmm.
But we, the three of us had planned out, like, a group lip sync, we planned out our own lip syncs, and we went to this party, and it was just, like, we didn't have costumes, it was literally just a floodlight in someone's backyard at night, and
you're
we,
like, a single spotlight, that's single all I
that's
need.
All I need, right? Just, and light, right? Just yeah. focusing on me. And so we did this lip sync battle, and a bunch of people had, like, done lip syncs. And then we ended up doing, like, multiple lip syncs, like, just on the fly, like, songs that we knew we would
yeah.
lip sync to them.
Just for
and
fun.
And it was just, like, silly and fun, but we kept doing it. It was super fun. People were really loving it.
Yeah.
And at the end, a high schooler won. And so a high schooler won, and he, put in quotes, because I don't agree. But a high schooler won because he did, like, Sexy I Know It stripped down to his speedo and everyone won. Well, then
like,
afterwards,
fine. Yeah,
we're like, fine. Oh gosh, okay, mm-hmm. we get it. Sex sells. And so we did. But as at the end of the party, one of the people that were attending the party gave me and John each $50 separately.
Wow.
And so he said, what? And he had said, you know, I would pay more to go to like a comedy show, like a good comedy show. And then you guys were so funny, and it was so fun, and all of that. And so we're
yeah.
like, oh wow, so we technically won too. That sort of was the impetus. We did like a couple, like another one after that was super casual. And then John's 21st birthday, because
mm-hmm.
We really liked it. He said he wanted it to be a lip sync battle for his 21st
yeah.
birthday.
Because nothing can be small at the Albright House.
It nothing. Just,
we gotta,
no.
Yeah.
We were like, okay, but we leveled it up, right?
Yeah.
We leveled it up. And so we did a stage. Like he built the stage and he did some lights, like some stage lights. He had bought some stage lights. And I mean, it was just, like, very excessive. I mean,
mm-hmm.
I did... That first year, I had, like, 4 backup dancers, and it was, like, a 10-minute Beyonce medley. And it was just, like, so extra. But not a whole... Like, some costume changes, but I wasn't... it wasn't what it has evolved to for me, which...
The production value has just gone up.
And every year it's gotten bigger and bigger, and this is officially year five, like I said, from his... So this is his 25th birthday. Mm-hmm. And we... I mean, at this point, I am doing full drag. I mean, I'm in full drag. Yeah. I am doing the full moment. And so it's just become this great production. And we have a trophy. All the winners get... I won, and Sean, if you've been watching Sean from previous episode. Yes. He and I both won the first year we tied, and so we both won. And then every year... And we got on the trophy, and then every year we've had a new winner. We're not allowed to win twice until next year.
Next year, everything restarts.
Everything's reset.
And
so
it's anybody's game.
I'm going crazy, going freaking crazy next year. So.
Well, that's what I love about, like, the fact that it started from just being such a big, like, family affair of, like, you know, you guys are so on fire for it every year. Like, seeing you guys set up for this last year, like, your parents are so into it, like, and for those of you who don't know, it's like they do this in the backyard. They set up a stage, lights, there's, you know, they set up light cues and everything. It is a full, there's tables out there you guys set up, and it's like a full production.
Yeah, it's a full party. I mean, like, it's literally evolved to, like, an open bar. Like, my parents, you know, my mom's a friend, Veronica, shout out to Veronica,
who bartends. Yeah.
And she, like, comes and will bartend, and, you know, she just, like, takes tips or whatever, and it ends up being, like, this full, intense thing now, and it's so funny, because I think the original intent the first year, like, of John's 21st, the original intent, because of how it started, like, for us, it was very casual. We all kind of jumped up and did songs that first night when it was the real lip sync.
And they really plan just loose fun.
And I think the intention was for it to sort of be like that. Like, oh, plan some, but, like, also, if you want to hop up and do a song, you can't.
Right.
And it's just evolved so much, it's become a production, and no one will ever do that. Like, no one would ever just hop up and be like, oh, yeah, I'll totally, you know, just
do this song. People now, like, plan, like, months ahead of time.
Well, you were part of the winning number this year.
Ding,
hello.
Ding, ding. Yes,
incredible.
Michael Pinning, who is you've seen on Artist Spotlight, me and him, one, you'll see a clip of this in a little bit, but yeah, my first year was last year, and we, like, heard from John and you guys just, like, how involved you guys get, and I was just like, I want to go, but if I'm going to go, I'm going to perform. So, yeah, it was just like... So fun, though.
It's what's cool, too, is I think, like, if you hear about it and you're like, it's a lip sync battle party, and people are like, okay, cool. And every person I've ever had come that doesn't really know the first year, they're like, this is way more than I thought it was. I mean, literally, like, I mean, as you know, we have, like, a lighting designer. We have lights, light cues. I mean, we have...
When you're like, oh, it's in our backyard, you're like, okay, let's see.
It's just this big event. And what's cool about lip sync, what I love about lip syncing is that it doesn't require talent. Not that I'm not talented. I'm just kidding. But it doesn't, you know, ultimately what it's all, when you boil lip syncing down, it's all about, like, selling it and just believing what you're doing. And I think, to me, that's what performing really is about, is suspending, you know, the creating this, you know, facade, right? Any kind of performing is about being in the moment.
Yeah.
And so I think what lip sync does is you don't have to be a singer. You don't have to be a great dancer. But ultimately, it's, do you sell it? Are you, like, fully in it? That's what makes a good lip sync, no matter what.
Yeah, it's the face. It's the personality.
Face, and the preparation, I think, is a big part of that as well. But, yeah, I think that's what's really fun about it. And anyone can do it, right? I mean, again, like, you don't have to be a singer. You don't have to be a dancer. You can create a lip sync. And it is sort of more comfortable for people, I think, who aren't naturally performers. Though there is a point of contention in my family that... all of, because people just kind of feel like, you know, those of us that already have done performing before, like, should not be allowed to do it or whatever, because it's not fair to people who aren't performers, because we are, you know, kind of crazy and stuff. But, I mean, you know, we make it work.
Try to make it open for everyone. Yeah,
for sure. No, it's good.
We're going to show a clip of this last year from a couple of weeks ago, and so many amazing performances on this. Check out this montage. We're going to show it right now.
Poor unfortunate souls, it's sad, but true. They come flocking to my cauldron.
It smells as a beast.
Do I help them?
Well, yes, I do.
Yeah.
There you go. There's a clip from Lip Sync 2021. So much fun. Bobby, we will save your clip for the end of this. So people get the full experience. Because, like, that is also my favorite thing when people who are performing or something like that, they're like, it's no Bobby, but we'll make it work.
And I'm
like,
I mean,
like, they're like, oh, yeah, Bobby's going to be the best for last. But, like, you know,
yeah. We'll do it. I mean, it's funny this year, like, I don't like being last, but yeah. I end up always being towards the end of the show. And this year I was, like, last. And I don't like being last because I don't really drink as much before. I'm not an alcoholic, I promise. Right. But
if you're watching this.
If you're watching, I'm not an alcoholic. But it's like, I don't want to get too, like, slosh before I go on, right? Sure. So that's kind of like, so I have like a drink, and so when I'm last, I just like wait, you know, I'm not really drinking. I mean, my whole thing is like, this has become like my time to do drag, basically. Yeah. And by no stretch of the mind am I what I can call myself a drag queen. I mean, in the sense that like, I can't do my own makeup. So,
right. Yeah.
I mean, I literally get it done. Someone does it. Someone helps me with my wigs. Mm-hmm. But it's so fun. And then also, like, I've now evolved to doing a, like, pre-party look.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. You and then full outfit before.
I have a full look before. And then I have a performance look. And, but yeah, I mean, it's super fun. I mean, this year, it's so funny as I felt like I really slapped this one together at the end, like, at the last week or two. But yeah, I mean, it's always fun, and I think, yeah, I don't know.
It's such like a, like, because you used the before look, and then you have your show look. It's like, because Sean Conn, you saw in that clip, he did Ursula.
Oh, gosh,
he did. Yeah, we saw him come in full, like, black veil.
I know.
And, like, you know, it's like, there's going to be a big reveal. And that's the thing, it's like, you, Sean, a lot of people now, like, continue to, like, make sure, like, the excitement level, you know, it's, you're always topping yourself, which is fun.
That's the goal, right? I mean, the goal for me, I mean, even though I haven't been eligible since the first year, to win, it's, like, my goal is always to, like, push it a little bit more, make it a little bit more challenging, and, you know, it's, like, again, it's so funny, this is, like, our backyard lip sync battle, but I think they're, like, for the people that do come to it all the time, like, there is, like, a level of expectation that I will, you know, start, bring some level. Yeah. And this year was particularly crazy for me because I am a teacher now, and so I teach at high school. Awesome. And it was the first week of school, so it fell on the first week of school for me. Yeah. And so just like prepping for it is a lot of work, and like choreography and backup dancers.
Finding a costume beforehand, you're ordering costumes like months ahead of time.
I pre-ordered that's the one thing I like pre-planned is my costumes, but like I bought my costumes and then I was going to do a different plan. So I always have like 3 or 4 like lip sync ideas that I always float around, and I end up landing on one of them that will work for that year.
Mm-hmm. So because there's like a theme every year too.
There is a theme, right? I don't ever do my lip sync to the theme, but yes, there's a theme. There's a theme, like, the goal of the theme really is for everyone else that's attending the party. Mm-hmm. So I always have like my pre-party look be like to the theme.
Yeah.
So it's like 70s this year, and I went a little 60s, but I went very hippie. And
the long hair.
I had like long hair and this like very hippie dress, and so that I always try to address to the theme at the beginning, but then my lip sync is sort of whatever I want it to be.
Totally.
Because you don't necessarily win points for the lip sync being in theme. Mm-hmm. And so this year I landed on, it sort of just worked out. Like I always try to think about, the way I plan my lip syncs is like, I listen to songs that I like a lot.
Yeah.
Obviously, I mean, that's what most
people
do.
That's the point.
Yeah. Well, that's what most people do, right? We just listen to songs we like.
Good.
I listen to music I like. It's pretty crazy. And
Bobby listens to music, you guys.
Thank you. But I start to think about, okay, like, what songs am I drawn to? Mm-hmm. How would I make a lip sync about it? So I have, I have a couple ideas still that I haven't used. And I'm like, but this year I landed sort of on this, like, idea of, like, female empowerment.
Yeah.
And like women and like, you know, empowering women, which is just, it's sort of ironic because I'm a man dressed as a woman, I identify as a cis male, and like, you know, I'm dressing as a woman about female, like, you know, performing about female empowerment.
Yeah, yeah.
And so I almost didn't do it. Cause I was like, is it offensive if I'm like, yes, like we are the, you know, and I'm like, but I'm actually, you know, I'm a drag queen at that point.
All, yeah.
And so I was like, is this offensive? But it was fine. I dedicated to all the women in my life. And
such a great montage at the beginning of it. It was great.
Yeah. So extra.
Was lip sync like your first like venture into drag and doing drag?
Yeah. I mean, well, let me think. Yes.
Like performing in drag, I guess?
Yeah, that was probably, so my third my second year. I guess it was the second year
yeah.
of doing Lip Sync Battle. I guess that was the first time doing any kind of drag. Yeah. And I did a really dove in because I did S&M by Rihanna. And
because if you got to start somewhere.
If you're going to do it, then do it. But, you know, and so I had like a full body latex suit.
Mm-hmm.
And I, what I revealed to that, I always do a reveal, yeah. I feel like.
Always
and
a big reveal.
Always yeah. a big reveal. Always
watch RuPaul, you gotta have
gotta
big reveal.
Reveal, gotta have pieces.
Yeah.
And I, and it was drag, and if you watch that, that video is, I mean, I look busted. But, busted. And so, and it was just because, you know, we didn't know what we were doing with drag, we just sort of kind of went for it.
Yeah.
And it was sort of, my makeup was a mess. And then, mm-hmm. and then after that, I also started doing drag. So I do drag twice a year, is what I always say. Is that lip sync battle and Halloween sometimes.
Yeah. And your Halloween looks are always fire.
Always extra, too. we always have a theme, always doing the most. And yeah, so, yeah. But yeah, so I, it, but yes, that actually, it's funny, I didn't really realize too. Honestly, it was sort of my, like, first dipping my toe into doing drag.
Mm-hmm.
And I watched RuPaul's Drag Race, and I love drag, yeah. And it's just fun. Like I said, I don't consider myself a drag queen in the
it's
sense.
It's like so fun to just like, you know.
Yeah, I play recommend the parts it. And stuff, you know? Yeah, I recommend it to anyone. Yeah. I mean, any person, any you know, doesn't matter person. I mean, doing drag is something you become this like other character. Yeah. And so
I mean, we all you know grew up doing theater together, so there's mm-hmm. that kind of theatricality that you know comes with it too, and having fun with the audience and all that fun stuff. It's like.
Oh, yeah. I mean, it's like, you know, like any type of performing, when you have the wig, the makeup, the costume, you're suddenly like, I am that character. And when I'm in drag, I'm like, I am that bitch. I mean, I literally feel like, I mean, I watch myself back and I'm like, I need to really work on like not feeling myself so much. Because like, when I'm in drag, I'm just like, ugh.
But it's a confidence boost. It's
I'm
like
just
a
like,
totally...
But I start to look like I just like don't even care about anyone. Because like, I don't, because it's just me.
It's just me and the stage.
Yeah,
yeah.
Just me, exactly.
You
so
the goal. Yeah.
Totally. But, so, but yeah. It's super fun. I mean, yeah, but it, yeah, it's a great time. It's a great kind of outlet for to be creative, and then also for me to do drag once a year or so. It's
for
really
sure.
Fun.
That's awesome.
Do you have a favorite drag look that you've done? Like,
ooh,
what's
that's
your
a really
one?
Good. I actually think my favorite look I've done is from this lip sync battle. And the reason is, I mean, my makeup and wig, I just have never, like, that was, it was just, my face was so together. And mm-hmm. this is the first time I think that. And then the bodysuit that you'll watch in the clip is like, so, like, fitted well, and I had corseted, like, in proportion. So, like, part of doing drag is, like, making my body look like a female body.
Like,
and
I
so,
feel like hot stuff.
Yeah,
right yeah
it
yeah.
just, yeah, and it just, you know, I was corseted, and I was padded on my hips a little bit, and you can kind of see, and I was a little worried, because some of the padding's a little questionable, but it all looked, correct, you know,
yeah.
and so
yeah.
I think that's probably I like that look, because I feel like that's the best I've looked in drag.
Yeah.
But every time I do it, I feel like I look a little bit better, hopefully. It's
yeah,
kind of
totally.
The goal,
yeah,
because so.
What were your other looks? So, like, last year was Carole Baskin.
Yeah, last year I did a whole Carole Baskin number. That
incredible.
Was incredible. That was ridiculous. That ended with me pouring blood on myself, fake blood on myself.
Yeah.
Which did stained everything. And,
yeah.
whole
stage is covered.
Yeah, that was covered in blood. And,
incredible.
And then, yeah, so I did that. Before that in lip sync, I did the third year. So that was my fourth year was Carole Baskin. That
mm-hmm.
was this year. And then third year was, I was in China. So I had actually gone out to teach theater in China that
oh,
summer.
Oh yeah, that's right.
And
yeah, yeah.
I originally, my dates were going to conflict with lip sync. And so mm-hmm. I wasn't going to go. So I'd already told John, honestly told my family, like, I'm not going to be here for lip sync battle. And it was a bummer. And I was
yeah.
like, oh my gosh. Well, then my dates got shifted back a week, but I just didn't tell John, and I didn't tell my parents.
Big surprise.
And I literally had been in San Diego for a week secretly.
Oh,
and,
my gosh.
And I, you know, I lived in my condo at the time and
uh-huh.
Had prepped my lip sync. And so my siblings knew, except for John,
mm-hmm.
and my parents didn't know, and I literally surprised them. So, like, I showed up as the first number. I recorded this whole video. It said, like, so sorry I can't be there. Here's some advice. Like, this whole, like, kind of
right.
fake video.
Yeah, yeah.
I'd recorded two versions. One that was just, like, in case John made my sister show it to him first.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And then I made another one, and which is the one we played, which was, I'm sorry, can I come? And then I said, oh, and one more thing. If you think I'm going to miss this... Oh, gosh, can I swear on here?
Bleep it out. Yeah.
If you think I'm going to miss this lip sync, then you got me bleeped up. And I just showed, and I appeared. And what's so crazy about that performance is, as in drag, and my dad didn't know it was me the whole time.
Oh, my gosh.
Literally came up to me. So it's so funny. I got off stage,
yeah.
and I was, like, you know, whatever, walking around. And he kind of was awkward, and he was like, "Oh, great job," and but like very like weird.
Didn't
I was like,
know. His...
But I thought, oh, I'm in drag. Like maybe he's weak, feeling uncomfortable about it. And then, literally middle of the party, he came back up. He's like, "Bob." And I was like, yeah. And he was like, I thought you were in China. He was so confused. He did not get it.
The wholesome reveal is totally...
But, well, it turns out it wasn't just him. Other people in the audience who know me, like, did not realize, like, even though I had a video that sort of alluded to it, did not realize it was me. They thought I'd, like, send someone else. So right. That makes the lipstick way more confusing.
Your stunt double came in.
Yeah, so I ended up... And so I tricked him.
That's so funny.
Yeah. Oh,
that jumpsuit was... awesome.
Oh, this year's?
The gold one that you had.
Oh my gosh. That was the year of the China one. It was so good. And I've worn it. It's done. It's seen its last days on my body because it is, you know, it's been worn out.
We're playing in the Albright Museum of Hall of Fame.
Oh, that started. John has started collecting, like, literally collected lip sync items. So one of these years, we're going to have a Hall of Fame, like as you come into the lip sync battle, like different costume pieces and items that are from lip syncs past. Well, year 10, the goal.
Yeah.
This isn't official. I can't speak for the John's lip sync battle. I can't speak for it. But there are talks of year 10 being an All Stars year.
Oh,
so every year we get a new winner. Well, now we could see some doubling up because we're all eligible again. Mm-hmm. But whoever has won, but you know, people have won in groups like you and Michael, so you guys could compete separately. So you could get 10, you know, enough like 10 numbers. Jesse and Dallas won last year, and so we'd split them up, and we'd have an All Stars year of just like year 10 being just the ultimate, the winner of all the winners.
That's when we do full recall, and then we just film like us prepping.
We just do pre-interviews.
Super fun. We're gonna show your clip from this year really quick. And it's so good. Enjoy. And enjoy our two backup dancers, Megan and Kara.
Yes. Shout out to them. They did all the work. I didn't do it.
Incredible. Check this out.
Let's go, girls.
Now, let's be honest for a second. Being a woman is not without its struggles, but I can only imagine the biggest struggle of all is finding someone that can handle all the woman you are.
What you say? You ain't know? Texas women do it bigger.
I say that so.
In the South, it gets no real baby. Pot full of grit. Then your mama's supper boy. Better get with it. Better watch your mouth. I might bite on your boy. Go downtown. Go to work. Good Lord, I deserve. If you're scared, go to church. Woo woo, I'm a love. Hold on tight, little country boy. I ain't no girl, I'm a boss with orders. All I'm needing is a baby love me like a warm biscuit on a Sunday morning. I got what you want. I'm aiming to please. I got what it takes. I sure got the means. I got what you want. honey iced tea. All eyes on me. Oh, oh baby. I'm a whole lot of woman.
From the way I walk and talk, my hips.
I'm a whole lot of woman.
From the sound of my voice to the gloss on my lips.
I'm a whole lot of woman.
Anything I see, I won't knock it. I'm a strong, bad ass chick with classic confidence.
Yeah.
Ain't no competition, baby. It's just can you keep up with me? I can't do a thing about my wicked ways with gravity.
Incredible.
Thank you.
Beautiful.
Thank you
work.
So much. I am the moment. Thank you.
The iconic fan at the end.
I know. That was a last minute add.
Oh my gosh.
Sometimes I like add stuff at the last second. I'm like, oh, I can add this fan at the end. And yes. So like I literally will like pop things at the last second. I mean, that costume, I forgot to shout out. I mean, Kat Pinning literally made those boots. Those boots that
oh
I was
gosh.
Wearing, they matched my costume.
Because it was like denim?
So it's like yeah. a denim bodysuit. So it's not really denim. It looks yeah. like denim. But in
fake denim, phenom.
Yeah, it's like phenom. Yeah,
yeah,
sure.
Yeah, sure.
And I had these black knee-high boots. They're black from last year's Lip Sync as Kara Baskin.
Oh, my gosh.
And I gave them to Kat, and I was like, can you, our friend Kat, mm-hmm. I was like, can you turn these to match my costume? And she literally painted them white, like glued that denim on, bedazzled the whole things. So they
crazy.
Matched this, that costume. And now I have these incredible, and those boots are
beautiful.
So good.
They're
yeah.
so cool.
Shout out to Kat Pinning. She's rad.
Yeah.
Yeah.
She's got to come on the show. It'll be good.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah, she's
if you're
awesome.
Listening to this, Kat, that'd be good. Yeah. So good. So we are going to play a game.
Okay.
And this is a game we like to call, what?
That's
it. That's
just
it.
What?
Just what? Because that's what you'll be doing when you're... Anna, do you want to explain the game for us?
Sure. So Bobby's going to start out. He's going to have the headphones on. And we're going to play some loud, random music, and he's not going to be able to hear us. So we are going to lip sync, and he's going to try and guess what song we are lip syncing.
So this is yeah. more about your talent, less about mine.
Yeah,
yes.
Right, yeah.
But you will get to shine when Tyler gets
oh,
to guess.
Oh, great.
Right, right.
Yes.
Yeah, so we'll be singing a different song than... Like, he'll be listening to a different song than we are singing.
Yes.
Play no other song.
I know. We tried to go with a diva theme.
Okay, incredible.
Yeah.
Let's see. And watch me not know the songs. Okay, here we go.
Yeah, and you can play it and
let me see.
Turn it up loud enough. It doesn't matter if you can hear us because we'll just be like...
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
We'll try not to sing it loud.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. It's pretty loud.
You
oh, my gosh. So loud.
You good, though?
Yeah, no, I definitely am good.
Okay.
What are we doing?
Do.
Are we starting?
Okay.
Oh my God, so loud.
Yeah, we're starting.
Yeah, we're good. Yeah, we're sure.
Which one
do you
want to
do? Thing
okay.
First.
Which one?
Thank you. Next. Thank you. Next.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Do you want me to play it?
Yeah, you can play it.
Okay. Ready?
Already? Okay. Listen, oh wait, no. Oh my God, I have no idea, it's so hard. It's so hard with other music. Once I'm in love, once, patience. Once I'm in pain, I'm in patience. Patience? Oh my God, this is so
hard.
What,
almost
there.
Do the chorus.
Wait, hold on. Thank you next! Thank
yay!
You next, Ariana Grande! Oh my God. Can I take this out?
Yeah.
This is so hard. Because I have another
so
song
good.
Blaring in my ears.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
We'll
that's
do an
so
easier
hard.
One for you so
yes.
you can get this one.
You want to
well,
get
th- next thank
one?
You next feels like it would be easy. Oh God. Okay, ready? Okay, hold on.
Okay.
Okay.
How does it. Do you want me to play it?
Yeah, sure, okay. We can play it. playing RuPaul for him on this
track. So loud. Is this the Broadway? Oh, no, it's not. It's
right. Yeah, this is perfect. Okay. Wait for it.
Are we going?
Yeah, we're
going. Okay. Oh, we're going. Let it go.
There you go.
Okay. I knew that one.
Yeah.
Good, good. Oh my gosh.
Easy. Wow. Yeah. It is so hard to hear.
You want to do one more?
Yes.
No, hold your mic.
Let it go is good. Oh, sorry. I'll put it back on. Hold on. Oh, God.
I don't know that.
You don't know that one?
I don't know the exact lyrics.
Okay.
But we can. I can.
Ready?
It's almost funnier.
Are we going?
Yeah. I don't know this
one. Oh, call me mother.
Yeah,
call
good me mother. Job.
Yes.
Whoops. Did I just yell that? I did a lot of editing out of my episode. That's sorry. So
okay. Yeah. All right. Okay. Now I'm gonna. That's so funny. I'm gonna be so.
You don't know the. You don't know him. You don't know him. Okay. You don't know what we're doing?
I didn't know that. I didn't know the lyrics, all the lyrics of that one.
Oh, I do know the lyrics of that one. Okay, what are we going to do? Hold on.
Let's do...
Yeah, no, go easy on me. Okay. I will...
Do you want to do something easy?
Yes. What? Do you have any suggestion?
No, what do you think?
I have Rain on Me, Man of...
Oh, that, let's do Rain on Me. Rain on me. I forgot about that one. Okay.
Ready? Okay, are we going? Okay, here we go.
We're just lip syncing, right? We don't have to sing.
I was playing it, so we can listen.
Okay, good. Well, that's good, yeah. Okay. Can you imagine us trying
shoot all my own. Oh.
Here we go.
Coming down on me. Water misery. Coming down on me?
No.
Oh, let it rain on me.
Yeah.
Rain on me.
Yeah.
Rain on me. Yes. Oh my gosh.
Wow. Serving. Okay, incredible. It's hard.
Okay.
It's so hard.
This is too contrasting.
Two different selling. Yeah, I know. We're doing it differently.
Do you want to do...
Yeah, the movement will give it away. Should we try it without doing the movement?
Yes. And skip that first part where it's like, oh, thank you. Just start from the start.
Yeah, let's start from there. And then we don't make it too easy.
Yes, of course.
So we'll skip it.
Yeah. Ready?
Yeah. Ready.
Watch my lyrics. I know this one.
Oh. I'm up on him. He up on me. Yeah. Yes.
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 Good job.
Oh, we tried to not do the dance to make it harder.
Yeah. I start to like go with the rhythm now.
Yeah. Oh my god, it's so good.
Probably gonna be the same. We can just like gibber. So like,
do another one.
You
want to
do one more?
Sure.
Yeah. Sure. Let's do it. Let's get crazy.
Do you have one you want to do?
Let me see. Let's see. Should we? What would he know? What would he know? What would he know?
These are so loud.
I know it's so loud. Let's do something. I'm trying to think what's epic. I don't know. Divas. We could do for my lip sync. Like we do.
Yeah.
Man, I feel
like.
Yeah, that's easy. Yeah.
I actually have that on my list too.
Perfect. Okay, perfect. Let's do it. Here we go.
Okay. Okay, man, I feel like a woman.
You just said, let's go, girls! But just fully selling it.
Right,
completely
quiet. Oh,
too easy. Okay, too easy.
That's just a, I mean, classic.
Yeah, I mean, hello. I saw a really good meme and said, like, when I hear let's go, girls, I can just kick down a door.
Exactly.
Exactly that. Oh, okay, man. Here we go.
Let's
so,
see. Do you
want to
do, what's the one that they
stick
together, the Skylar Sisters?
Yes, that's that one. I can do that one. It's, isn't it called the Skylar Sisters?
I think I'm listening to Main Event right now.
Satisfied.
Yeah, I don't know if I know that well, but let's go for it. We'll get it. That's a better one.
Cool.
We're going female empowerment.
She's,
about the
same.
Yeah,
she's a diva. Oh, wait.
Oh,
that's the Hamilton mixtape.
Oh, hold on. Hold on, please hold. Keep going. Keep vibing, Tyler. We don't have to tell him twice. He's gone.
There we go. That's right.
Are we ready?
I don't know this part. Let's start with the lyrics. Ready? Okay. Here we go.
To the end, yeah, to the revolution. The commitment, the face.
Oh, we're in it to win it.
It
Hello.
Can happen anywhere, folks.
Hello. Oh,
I've been
my
right
gosh.
Here in the house in Santee.
That is so good. You didn't get to do one. Do you want to do one?
You want to do one?
Sure.
Let's just do, yeah. I mean, I don't know how much time we have. I don't want to put us too over, but yeah, we're good. Let's let you do one or two. Let's see.
Yeah.
Okay, Tyler, we gotta pick a good song.
Oh my gosh.
Okay, what?
Wait, I need your phone to. There you go.
Okay. We can't pick songs on her list because she'll know. We'll have to pick something different.
So. Okay, yeah, we'll work. We can pick a random song.
Whatever. Okay, what do we want to do?
Do we want to do like,
okay.
You ready to Beyonce?
Yeah, we're ready to Beyonce.
Do like Mariah Carey. We could do Whitney. Did we do Whitney?
No, we could do. What if we do, I Will Always Love You? Even though it's technically a Dolly Parton song. Whitney discovered it.
We could.
Just be honest. What other one? What's another Whitney?
Or we could do, Don't make me. I have nothing if I.
Oh, maybe nothing. I just don't know if I know if I have nothing left.
Yeah.
I think I could do. I can do.
I'll always love you.
I will always love you.
Okay, let's do it.
I think so. We'll see. I might regret this. Oh, here.
Okay, here we go.
Should stay. I would only be in your way, so I'll go, but I know, I'll think of you every step of the way.
Yes!
Incredible!
So good!
So fun!
It's a really slow intro. Yeah. I didn't realize. I didn't think about that.
Get to it. Yeah. Oh my god.
Okay,
gosh, so
we'll do one. Okay, ready for another one?
You
do
one?
Oh, I'll give you. Okay, this is my go to lip sync song. This is my first lip sync song I ever did. It's Listen by Beyonce.
Oh, yeah.
I know it to the T. We'll see how far I can get into it. I'm ready.
Okay, let's see.
I'm ready. Oh my gosh.
Here we go.
Put it right in.
But can't complete. Listen.
Yeah.
Yes.
I said that's my go. That was actually my first lip sync song I did. Is
really?
Listen. Oh yeah, it's that like party that we had originally done. It's like my I love it. It's my favorite song to lip sync to.
It's such a good song.
Oh, so fun.
Number.
Incredible.
Awesome. Great work, everybody.
So good. That was super fun. Oh my gosh.
Oh my gosh.
I love it.
You're so good at that.
Oh, yeah. Thank you.
Yeah.
So good. Oh my gosh. I love it. No, yeah. Lip sync is so fun. I think that's what's fun about it. Is it's like anyone can do it.
Mm-hmm.
And like the more you sell it, the more it's fun, right? And
yeah.
and it's like I don't like karaoke because karaoke is like I just don't like karaoke because it's like a talent comparison because
yeah.
It's like I don't know, and it's like you lip sync, it doesn't matter.
Totally.
The vocal's good. It's all you always do songs people love, and so everyone just has a good time. It's so
yeah.
super fun.
Well, then that's the for anyone who's out there who may be thinking of coming maybe next year, or someone who's just interested in maybe getting involved and. You know, trying drag or doing lip sync or doing something, you know, what would be some encouraging words that you could, you know?
Oh, okay. I like it. That's a good
yeah.
question. I think to me, number one is always have fun. Like whenever I'm doing a lip sync, I'm always having fun. Even if it's stressful to get it prepped, like I love doing it and I'm always choosing songs that I love. So
mm-hmm.
I think the number one thing is like the advice is like have fun. If it's something you want to do, again, I by no stretch of the mind am a drag queen. I'm not a drag queen. But like doing drag to me is something I wanted to do and just I've progressively sort of started to do it more. And again, if you want to do it, just do it. Find someone. If you don't want to do your makeup, because I don't, find someone who can do your makeup for you. I mean, there's lots of people that, you know, can help you with that. And try it. and just have a good time. I mean, no matter what you do, like, I think that's true in life, is as long as you're having fun and you're doing something you love, then, like, it's all good, and, like, it's all worth it.
I love that, and I love that you've, you know, like you said, you're a teacher, and you, you know, also enjoy doing all these things, and it's so cool to see that you've, you know, found an amazing balance of work and fun and, you know, doing all the things that you love. And I think that's really encouraging for anyone watching and for me and all that.
Thank you. That's the goal. I mean, do what you love and never work a day in your life. That's actually not true. You have to work a lot, but you always enjoy it, right? Yeah. You know, you're doing it for the right reasons. So totally. That's why I switched to teaching. That's why I perform still a little bit doing this. So it's fun.
Yeah.
It's good.
That's awesome. Thank you so much for being here, Bobby.
Thank you for having me. I had a great time. Yes. Thank you guys. I love it.
Thank you, Anna. Thank you, John. You guys are always great. For those of you watching, as always, the arts have the ability to heal and take us to incredible places and places that we can just have fun and do what we love. And we hope that this is a safe space where you feel that you can totally be yourself and have a good time and just, you know, have fun and get a little crazy and, you know, sing Whitney Houston to the top of your lungs. It's great. You can find us at In the Round with Tyler Tafoya on Instagram, Facebook, and YouTube. You guys have been great. We'll see you around. Bye-bye.
Bye. Bye.